What are AVNs? They are application virtual networks. In the next 10 minutes, you'll understand what they are, how they're used, and how to configure them. Better yet, we're going to go across terminology that you may see out in the wild. Cross-region segments, local region segments, the virtualized suite, placement, federation, all that sort of stuff we'll go through in this video. But before we do that, if you like my content, please like and subscribe below. It really does help me out.
Put simply, an AVN is just an NSX segment. Now, it can either be overlay or VLAN backed. An overlay segment utilizes Genève tunneling and NSX distributed logical routing. I won't cover that in depth in this series because it's not about NSX logical routing, but there is this really good book that covers all of that. VLAN back segments are just L2 segments like DVS port groups, but just in NSX. They open you up to other L2 or underlay issues that I won't go into here, but I have talked about in a previous video and I will continue to do so in future videos. AVNs are required to be able to deploy the vRealLife suite. So we're talking log insight, automation, network insight, VR ops or operations, lifecycle manager, and workspace access. There are two AVNs, the cross-region and the local region segments. The cross-region segment is stretched between regions with federation, or if you're using VLAN backed, then stretched VLAN.
I thought I'd take a pause here and really iron out the use case of VLANs and federation here. I wanted to make it absolutely clear that you cannot federate a VLAN back segment. It can only be an overlay segment as it goes through the edges and needs to be routed logically, all that sort of stuff, which we will cover in a future video. So remember, VLAN back segments, no stretching via federation, has to be all underlay layer 2 stretching. Overlay segments can be stretched with federation. All right, let's move on.
It carries appliances such as VROps, VRA, workspace access, cluster, and appliances essentially that manage all regions. The local region segment is for appliances that are locally specific. So we're talking things like log insight that you wouldn't want going across regions, and collectors for the specific region. To really get the picture across, we're going to go through two situations or scenarios. First one's federation. The cross region segment gets stretched across without using anything stretched in underlay, so no layer 2 stretching. We're using Genève tunnels and NSX federation with overlay routing across sites to get that subnet across. Let me just erase that. Now onto the VLAN use case. This to me is considered legacy. You've got a stretched layer 2 domain across both regions in the underlay. The gateway sits in the physical network. This creates a massive broadcast domain. Any spanning tree loops, any sort of looping or all those sort of issues will happen in your underlay and could take out both data centers. Adds administrative overhead, especially when you need to maintain and make sure there's no issues in the underlay. With all that said and done, the preferred option here would be to use overlay. Now, I've given you the reasons why. I won't explain it again, but make your own decisions, choose wisely. This can have great impact. Log into SDDC Manager, inventory, workload domains, and then for the management domain, click on the three dots, click on Add AVNs. Now you get the option to select what the AVNs are going to be used for, but you can't really choose anything because it's grayed out, so it's vRealLife suite. Then you've got to choose overlay backed or VLAN backed. I won't cover off what they're for again, but this is where you pick. Select your option and then click next. As I mentioned, we're going to use overlay in this demo. You can see why we built the edge cluster first. We need to select it and the gateway we built with it so the AVNs can be attached and plumbed through it. Click next once you've selected your edge cluster and tier 1 gateway. This section is all about AVNs and their details, the cross region and the local region to be specific. I'll populate all those details and we'll go through it quickly. We've got the details of the region A or local region network there. It's a slash 24 CIDR, it's an MTU of 9000. Then we've got the cross region network called X region, also a slash 24 network, MTU of 9000. All the other details are fairly standard. Hit next when done. Now you can see a summary screen of all the things we've configured. Just confirm it's all okay. Whoop, that went black, but I know the details are good. I'll hit finish and it will start building. As with anything SDDC Manager workflow related, you should be able to see the tasks in the tasks pane. You can see there that the task is still fetching and pending. There you go, successful. Let's validate in NSX, go to networking, segments. Okay, we've got local region, X region, the subnets have been defined. We can see it's plumbed to the WD tier 1 or the tier 1 gateway that was created earlier. Tier 1 gateway is there, so we don't need to really do anything there. Perfect, so that looks good. Now, as far as route propagation is concerned, we've got two new subnets that we need to advertise. Typically, you would need to enable route advertisement on the T0 and T1 gateways, but because this is part of a VCF build or an edge cluster build through SDDC manager, all of that stuff is checked for you. It's simple enough to check via the UI, but I don't want to do that in this case. I want to show you the top rack switches and the subnets that they can see. As you can see here, I've got a putty session to leaf one, and you can see two subnets advertised there, 10100 and 10101. That's the local region and the cross region. So that's exactly what you want to see. If you're not seeing this in your top rack switches or in your environment, just make sure there's no filtering when the routes are advertised. But as I said, that should not be the case in the VCF environment.
By now, you should have a better understanding of what AVNs are, how they're used, how to configure them, and better yet, how to validate them. I always suggest you try and go through this stuff yourself. I tend to learn better when I do things, but it's up to you how you choose to ingest this information. I hope you enjoyed this video, but if you want to understand the bigger picture of VCF architecture, click on this video. If you missed the deployment of the edges, click on this video, as that is a prerequisite to be able to deploy the AVNs, especially if you're going for an overlay back network. If they're VLAN back segments, as I've mentioned, you don't need edges. Catch you next time.